And let me tell you something. If you want to serve Jesus, you have to sacrifice your Sunday morning and show up to church. And there are a lot of people who don't want to make that sacrifice. How many people have I invited to church? Oh, Sunday's my one morning to sleep in. The service starts at 10:30. How late are you staying up on Saturday night? But you know, oh, that's my one morning. And if you would go to Matthew 13, but you know, oh, that's my one morning to sleep in. I just don't want to give up that one day. Well, you know what? You want Christianity to cost you nothing, is what you're saying. Oh, no, you know, I can't go soul winning because of the fact that, you know, that's my one night a week or that's this or that. But, you know, sometimes we got to make sacrifices and realize that, you know, you can't have everything in this world. You can't have it all. You can't be, for example, in my case, a fire-breathing, leather-lung Baptist preacher and then expect to also be buddies with the congressman and the mayor and the city council and to be invited to the presidential prayer breakfast. It's just not happening. So we have to make a choice in our lives. There's always the choice. Choose this day whom you'll serve. You can't serve God and mammon. Right. Paul said, you know, if I yet pleased men, I should not be the servant of Christ. So he said, do I now please men or God? He asked the question, do I now please men or God? You can't please both. And a lot of people are trying to have it both ways. You know, they want to have one foot in the world and one foot with the things of God. And they want to try to balance both and have both. And it's deceptive. It's not what David did, the man after God's own heart. He said, I want this to cost me something. I'm willing to pay the price to serve God, to serve the Lord. But let's look at Matthew 13, verse 20. The Bible says this, but he that receiveth the seed into stony places, the same as he that heareth the word, and anon with joy receiveth it. The word anon means immediately. It says, anon with joy receiveth it. Okay? Yet hath he not rooted himself, but dureth for a while. And when you see dureth, you can think endureth. He dureth for a while. For when tribulation or persecution ariseth because of the word, by and by he is offended. So what's the Bible telling us here? That basically there are people who are new believers, or maybe they just aren't really rooted and grounded yet in the faith, even if they've been saved for a long time. And that any little thing that comes along, they're offended. They're scared off. You know, there are people throughout history who've suffered real persecution for the cause of Christ. And the Bible says, yea, and all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. But there are people who've been thrown in prison. There have been people who've been beaten. There have been people who've been killed. And that there are Christians today in America that are even scared to even come to a church like Faithful Word Baptist Church. Oh, because there might be protesters on the public sidewalk. They might look at me. You weakling. You coward. You know what? It takes almost zero guts to come to this church. It's the easiest thing in the world. But there are some people who are so weak and so scared that literally they just want to go down to the other independent fundamental Baptist church down the street where it's a little more comfortable, a little less, you know, hype and controversy going on, and where they can go in and sit down and just chill out and everything's great. And you know what? There's really nothing wrong with what the pastor's preaching down there. It's what he's not preaching that's the problem. That's the trouble with most churches. It's not what they preach, it's what they won't preach. We as Christians need to be willing to make some sacrifices and endure some persecution and to give up some things because of the fact that, you know, that's what God wants from us. And if we love him, and, you know, then we're going to obey the word.